Hey folks, welcome to my Let's Play Everybody's Gone to the Rapture series. This is part 4. I'm playing around with a new headset today, so if the sound quality is a little off, that's why. Although hopefully it's better. Doesn't it violate some kind of, I don't know, video game fire code to not be able to use the fire extinguisher in game? Wonder if I can go in there. You know, as weird as it is that there are a million doors in this game and you can only open like 20% of them, I think it's kind of cool. I mean, it's like real life. You can only open about 20% of the doors that you encounter. the trouble with putting this game down for a few days before making another one of these recordings is that I've got absolutely no idea whether I'm going the right way or not. I'm guessing that most of what you just saw was Shelby going the entirely wrong way. So, sorry. Wouldn't it be wild if you could see your character's face in that rearview mirror? I was kind of hoping that might have been the case with the detail in this game that seemed sort of in character for the design. Hmm. Got absolutely no idea what this thing is wanting me to do.
Thank you. I lost my shoes, sir. There's arches on the green. They've taken my shoes, sir.
Howard, love them. You open the door this instant, young man.
I lost my shoes.
Now get up. Get up.
I lost my shoes.
What on earth are you doing here, Howard?
Steve, he told me to stay in case Lizzie phoned.
Steve, where is he?
What are you doing with those birds?
Concentrate, Howard. Where is Steve?
He said he couldn't help. He took my shoes, so I'd stay.
Listen to me, Howard. You find your shoes and you get to the village. Find Father Jeremy. He'll give you some soup or something. Be off with you.
Where are you going?
I'm going to find my son. Then I'm going to ask him what on earth he thinks he's doing.
I'm thinking this thing is wanting me to talk to it, but I'm tilting the controller exactly the same way I've been doing. There's not a darn thing happening. I'm starting to get kind of annoyed with the mechanics of this game.
Rachel, darling, I'm sorry about taking over your music, but that is your dad and I, in case you come home. I know Mrs. Graves is looking after you over there, but just in case you come home, we wanted to let you know we're going to head over to Bob's. Evie! Sam, I'm leaving a message for Rachel. Are you going to say hello?
Jesus Christ, Evie, we haven't got time for this. The bloody car won't start, we're going to have to walk.
Sam, shush, it's for Rachel in case she comes back here.
But Charlie says everyone's getting together at the hall. Rachel's at the camp, she'll be fine.
Rachel, darling, anyway, listen, as I was saying, we're going to be at the village hall. We'll wait there for you. I think it's best if you just stay put and mind what Mrs. Graves tells you. We love you, darling. Bye.
You finished? Right, grab that bloody case and let's get moving. Come on.
Wendy, wake up.
Eddie, is that you?
No, it's me. It's Frank.
Oh, Frank. The door was open. I didn't think Graham would mind.
I'm sure he won't. What are you doing here?
Looking for Stephen, but he just ran out of steam. And the door was open. Have you listened to the radio? I thought I heard him on the radio before.
You go to Stephen's house, and if I get hold of him, I'll tell him to come and find you.
Goddamn bloody thing! Jesus! Come on, not now!
Jesus, come on, you bastard!
Stop, you bastard! Come on!
Stephen, are you here? It's your mother. Answer me.
Somebody who's any good at math, tell me if this makes any sense. Because it's gibberish to me, but it might not be gibberish to you. I realize that's thinking a little optimistically.
Stephen, where is Kate? Are you here?